It's been a long time. Hi, how are you? In this video, we're gonna go over how you can get back some of that time that you feel that you're lacking, that you feel that you don't have enough hours in the day to do like all the things that you wanna do, and I get it. I still struggle with it myself. But here are just some tips that you can use to get some of that time back. Sometimes we just don't feel like we have a lot of time in our day, but wow. I mean, can you hear that? Like, it's not even raining. Oh my god, I'm gonna play tennis later. I got some new tennis, which I'm going to show you in a bit. Dude, of course. Like, I'm gonna show you how, like, I have the camera all set up. So I'm not gonna show you right now. I'm gonna record a video and then I'm gonna show you how the shoes that I used for playing are just all damaged. Poor shoes. They literally have a hole in them, and they're good shoes, dude, but they're not for tennis. Like, if you see the material for actual tennis shoes, you can notice the difference. Like, there's a big difference. Of course the shoes were gonna end up like that. So after that break, we're gonna go into the video. So as I said, sometimes we just don't feel like we have enough time in our day without sacrificing your health, sleep, and still doing the things you like. We can figure out a way to just get some chunks of our day back, because sometimes we waste time in things and we don't even, like, we're not even conscious about it. All right, so starting, how and why deleting social media is the best thing you can do. I don't care what everyone else is doing. I don't care if this friend or acquaintance is drinking a piña colada or at a big party with lots of alcohol and music. I don't care about the coffee someone is drinking at a nice cafe, like, that's nice, but you have to establish your priorities right now. Like, do you want to know what everyone else is doing, or do you want to focus on your own thing? Like, if you acquire the mentality, like, nah, I don't care about what everyone else is doing, I'm gonna focus on my own thing and I'm gonna do my own thing. When you delete social media, you're gonna gain a lot of time of your day back. Like, sometimes we just have this impulses to grab our phone mindlessly and open Instagram and start scrolling, and Instagram then leads to Facebook, and then Facebook leads to YouTube, and then YouTube leads back to Instagram, and then you're in a vicious circle. So by just removing all social medias, it's just gonna be a lot easier for you to have more time to concentrate. And still, that instant gratification that those apps give, it's just so bad for your brain. It's literally making people stupid. And I felt this too when I mindlessly started just spending a lot of hours, literally hours, on social media. Now, it's true that social media has a great advantage, but the thing is, use it in an intelligent way. Don't be just a consumer, be a creator, be a producer. You can use social media to build your personal brand, and then this, of course, is gonna help your business, but just know how to use social media. And to be a creator, you don't necessarily need to have it on your phone. So at least for, let's say, a week, 2-3 weeks, uninstall social media from your phone. And if you need to upload some content, do it from your computer. Like it's better that way. And if you really need to use it on your phone, install the app back, do what you need to do. Just go inside with a purpose, go back out when that's completed, and delete it again. So, like, if I have to use social media for any reason, let's say Instagram, I open it in the browser of my phone, I open it in Safari, I do whatever I need to do, and then I go back out, and that's it. I don't install it back, and if I do, I uninstall it right after. And even then, sometimes I still get caught up in mindlessly scrolling, mindlessly watching stories. So just be more conscious about what you're doing on social media. Now, this is a big one. Do not touch your phone for the first 30 minutes, hour, 2 hours after you wake up. Also, don't see any notifications after you wake up. Why? Because when you wake up, right, you are very receptive to anything. And if you start your day by seeing this message that has some bad connotation in it, some bad news, some stressful problem that you need to solve, what that's gonna do is that you're gonna start your day in a reactive way instead of in a proactive way. Let's say that you're one of those people who just wake up and then start a deep work session. Don't touch your phone while you are in that deep work session. And even if you're not doing any deep work right after you wake up, just hold yourself and don't grab your phone at least for the first 15 minutes of your day. Like just don't start in a reactive manner. Not using your phone as soon as you wake up, not seeing any notifications, it's going to help you increase your focus throughout the day and establish what you want to do throughout the day instead of just waking up anxious already, stressed because you saw this message, and maybe you woke up early and it's not even necessary for you to worry about it right now. It's still going to affect. Adding to this, you can see something which immediately grabs your attention, and now you can't focus on whatever you want to do or whatever you plan to do or like just in anything else, because you're thinking about the problem and that message someone sent, that notification. Like, even if you're not trying to start a business, this helps when you're in school. Do you really wanna go to school and already be anxious before the day even starts? That's not a good way to start your day. If you know you have an exam that you don't feel that prepared for, maybe you wanna learn a new language and you just can't find a time in a day to do that, or to read a book you really like, or you really wanna finish, just go to sleep a bit earlier, wake up a bit earlier, do not touch your phone for the first 15, 30 minutes, an hour, and do the thing which you want to advance, which you really want to dedicate time to. Maybe it's moving your business forward, maybe it's studying or reviewing for that exam, for that quiz that you have in school, in university. Maybe it's advancing reading that book, or learn or dedicate some time to learning that new language. Maybe, you know, just tasks which you want to do, you know that they are important, but you also know that you won't have time in a day, or like it's very likely that you will end up not doing it throughout the day. At least for iPhone users, there's this setting which you can turn on an option called not disturb, and you can choose which applications if you wanna add any exceptions. Like, maybe you say, okay, so for, this is what I do actually, for my mom and for my dad, notifications are always on. So even if I turn on the not disturb, I still get their notifications, but it will also avoid me getting just other notifications like emails, WhatsApps from friends and or from other family members while I'm trying to focus. So it's a really good option. It's not really like, if you just put your phone on silence, that's not enough. Just put it on not disturb, and it even has a lot of different options now. Like, you have the not disturb, you have personal, you have work, you can add a lot of things. And you can exclude different things depending on the not disturb. Maybe in one you wanna turn off the not disturb for Slack, let's say, because you're working with Slack and you need to be like, and you need to be aware of any notifications sent by team members or by clients. But you don't wanna be disturbed by other things such as emails or just messages, random messages from Instagram, Facebook, Twitter. So you can exclude that and label it as work. Or if, for example, you want to read, you want to dedicate some time to personal development, you can put personal. In my case, this one is called personal, and absolutely nothing is and absolutely nothing is excluded from personal. So I get no notifications while this is turned on, and I can focus on my reading, on my personal development learning task, whatever. Okay, and last one, don't underestimate this one. You really gotta practice it and include it in your day-to-day. Learn to say no. I struggle still with this, I know. Everything you say yes to, remember, everything you say yes to, you're saying no to something else. Of course, you have your priorities and you wanna maybe help a friend or a family member even with a task they have, or maybe they, I don't know, they ask you to go to a party or something. Just learn to say no. Know your priorities, set them straight, write them down and repeat them to yourself daily, because those are the ones, those are the things that are gonna move you forward.
Yep, it's definitely raining now. This, I know they're a bit dirty. These are the shoes that I used to have. I mean, yeah, I mean, definitely not for tennis. Look at this. I mean, just compare the material. This is hard. I mean, although these are pretty heavy, definitely gonna be a bit harder to play with.
So to finish out this video, you can say whatever you want and believe whatever you want to believe about success, but you'll be miserable during your journey to becoming your better self, your 2.0 rich. You'll find yourself being lost, exhausted, burnt out if you don't enjoy the process, and if you constantly just deprive yourself of that which you love to do, like to do, rest. Enjoying the process is the best tip. Have a great day.